Okay, eighth graders, this is pre-algebra, and today we are talking about angle relationships. And we have a few guests in the math room with us today. We have Owen Marcel and Omar M. So
hi.
Let's
hi.
Give a shout out hi. To them.
What?
Okay, so we're going to talk about some angle relationships here. This is the video. To watch for our next class, we are going to have four different kinds and then a kind of a bonus one at the end. So first, number one, we are going to talk about adjacent angles. Now, that's kind of a big word that we don't really use a lot. Adjacent means next to. So adjacent angles, they're next to each other. They share a side. So I'm going to draw you an example here of some adjacent angles. First of all, that's an angle right there. That is one angle. This middle part is the angle. So this part right here, that's the actual angle. Okay? Now the adjacent angle, it shares this side right here. So this is angle one and this is angle two. We say that angle one and angle two are what we call adjacent angles. So they're next to each other, okay?
Okay.
Then we've got some special types of adjacent angles. So number two, we have, and we talked about these in seventh grade, so this shouldn't be brand new, complementary angles. And complementary angles are two angles that equal 90 degrees. Right? And when we have two angles that equal 90 degrees, they're going to look like a right angle. So I'm going to put in parentheses here the word corner, because corner starts with C and complementary starts with C. So I'm going to underline that letter C in both of those, because complementary angles make a corner. So that would be 90 degrees. Now, usually they are adjacent, which means they are next to each other. But not always, so I'm going to show you both examples. So here's one example. Okay, those are a right angle because that's what equals 90 degrees. And as you can see here, they are adjacent because look, this is the side that they share, right? So if this angle is 30 degrees, this angle has to be 60 degrees because they equal 90 degrees together. You guys hear, I hope. Don't know if you can hear the band.
Yeah, it's Kristen and Wyatt. Say hi.
Okay, we can hear the band in here, but I don't know if they'll be able to hear it on the video. Okay, another type of angles that are complementary, they look could look like this. And we would say that this angle right here is 27 degrees. And to find the missing angle, we would take 90 minus 27, which is 63, so this angle would be 63 degrees. But we can see that both of those angles together make a corner. Now remember I said they don't have to be adjacent, so they could look like this. They could look like right here, and then this one could be right here like this. And you see how they're not adjacent, they don't share that side, but they're close to each other. But together, they're still complementary. Yeah, that's not a very good right angle. I should try that again. I'm going to try that again. There, that's better.
Oops.
Okay. So you can see, if I would turn that, how they would make 90 degrees. So if this angle here is 41 degrees, and that's x, we would take 90 minus 41, which would give us 49. So that's 49 degrees. Okay? All right, I have a secret problem for you to do like this. So I'm going to draw this right here. This is your secret problem. What?
This is easy.
Okay, if this is x and this is 11 degrees, I would like you to find the value of x. Okay? Now we have our next kind of angle, which is number three, which is, I got to extend here, Number three is supplementary angles. Now we did complementary, and that made a corner. And it equaled 90 degrees. What do you suppose supplementary equals together? Think in your head what it might be. And it's two angles that equal 180. And I like to say that they make a straight angle or a straight line because both of those words start with an S. So I'm going to underline those S's there. So supplementary starts with an S and straight starts with S. So they're going to look something like this. So if this angle is 125, how would you suppose we'd find that missing angle? That's right, we take 180 minus 125, which gives me 55 degrees. Let's try another example. Here we go. And if this angle right here is 75 degrees, I'm gonna take 180 minus 75, and that's gonna give me 105 degrees. Okay, now you'll notice both of these pairs are adjacent. That means that they share a side. But remember, with complementary, they didn't have to share a side. So with supplementary, they also do not have to share a side. So I'm going to show you an example like that now. Okay, so here's what it would look like. Okay, so do you see how they don't share a side, but you can see how they fit together to equal 180 or to make a straight angle? So if the angle on the right is 37 degrees and I'm trying to find X, I would just take 180 minus 37 and I'd get 143 degrees, so X is 143 degrees. Okay, I have a secret problem for you here now. Erase this quick. I'll do it in red. So here's your secret problem. And so here are my two angles. That two angles here, I have angle one and angle two. So angle one, if it's X, and angle two is 156 degrees, I'd like you to find the value for angle X. All right, I'd like us to just really quick, look, this red angle, the red two angles here are supplementary. These right here are complementary. Look right now and see the difference. Notice the difference between the blue, the red. Got it? All right. Okay, next we've got number four, and number four is vertical angles. And vertical angles, these are a little different. They are made by intersecting lines, and I'll explain that in a minute. We're almost done. To me, vertical angles are kind of the easiest. They're vertical angles, they're made by intersecting lines, and they are congruent. And that's what this little symbol means, congruent. I'll put that in parentheses, congruent. We used that a little bit in seventh grade. That means congruent, that means they're the same. They measure the same. So if one of them's 20 degrees, the other one's 20 degrees. So here are intersecting lines. There's two lines, they intersect. That means they cross each other right here. That's where they intersect. Now, I have four angles that are made here. Here, this opening on the left is an angle. I'm going to call it angle one. On the top, that's angle number two. On the right, angle three. And on the bottom, angle four. So those are my four angles. So when I have two intersecting lines, it makes four angles. The vertical angles are the ones that are congruent. So it's angle two is congruent to angle four. Those are vertical. And I think you're probably remembering this from last year. And angle one is congruent to angle three. And those are vertical. Okay? All right. So if I tell you that angle two is 97 degrees, we know right away that angle four is also 97 degrees. And now I know what you're thinking. Ms. Cook, how do we find angles one and three? I can see your hands there saying, Well, let's look here at two and four and three. What do they make? They make a straight line. How many degrees are in a straight line? That's right, 180 degrees. So I'm going to take 180 minus 97. And I get 83 degrees. That means that this is 83 degrees. And because 1 and 3 are vertical, angle 1 is also 83 degrees. That's pretty slick, huh?
Yep.
All right, let's do one more, and then I have a secret problem for you. Is that too fast? Go ahead. Okay, let's look at this one right here. I'm going to label these 5. Look how I label them. 6, 7, and 8. I did them a little different. And I'm going to say that angle 7 is 23 degrees. Now, let's think to ourselves, which angle is vertical with angle 7? Which one's right across from it? Angle 8. So right away, I know angle 8 is 23 degrees because 7 and 8 are vertical. 5 and 6 are also vertical.
But look what 5 and 7 make together.
They make a straight line, which means they equal 180. So to find angle 5, I take 180 minus 23, which gives me 157. So if angle 5 is 157, angle 6 is also 157. And I have a secret problem for you here with the vertical angles. I'm going to give you one of the angles, and you need to find the other three. I'm going to tell you that angle 1 is 134 degrees, so I would like you to find the other three angles, and then I have about 30 more seconds, and then we're done. The last thing I want to tell you is there's a special kind of intersecting lines, and that is perpendicular. Oh, our secret word today is chicken. So perpendicular lines, they also intersect, but they make 4 right angles. So I'm going to draw this picture and then we're done. So we've got 2 lines that intersect and they make 4 right angles. So each one of those angles is 90 degrees. And that's all I have for today. I hope you have a great day and we'll see you on Monday. Bye-bye.